New Hampshire's DNA database is the smallest in the country, but today a House subcommittee unanimously passed an expansion bill. It'll hit the full House in January. That makes the grieving mother of murder victim Bonnie Craig very happy.
It's been 15 years since Bonnie Craig's body was discovered raped and beaten in a ravine in Alaska. 2 years ago, investigators found a DNA match to this man, Kenneth Dion, serving time in New Hampshire for armed robbery. Karen Foster believes that if New Hampshire was more proactive on collecting DNA for all felons, her family would have seen justice much sooner.
He was in jail 2 months before he murdered her, out on parole when he murdered her, and then back in jail 2 months after he murdered her. It took almost 13 years before he was identified by DNA.
Karen Foster flew up from Florida to testify Tuesday in favor of a bill that would require all felons convicted in New Hampshire to give a DNA sample. Right now, only people convicted of a violent felony, like a murder, robbery, kidnapping, or a sex crime, have to give DNA. An expansion would include crimes like felony vandalism, where the damage exceeds $1,000, or grave tipping.
The problem with any kind of broad sweep such as this is that there are crimes included which I think most people would sit back and say, huh?
The Attorney General's office likens DNA to a fingerprint and says it's just one of many investigative tools to help solve crimes. And Foster insists this mysterious string of numbers and letters is far less invasive than a mugshot being made public.
It doesn't have your name. It does not have any race issues. It doesn't have medical information, psychological information. It is like a barcode. There is no privacy issue there.
The DNA collections end up in the FBI's database. In New Hampshire's case right now, that even includes DNA from some minors because their crimes fit the state's requirement for collection. This new bill would exclude juveniles but keep the samples that they already have. The man charged with killing Kimberly's daughter goes on trial next April. Reporting live, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.